In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve a 4x4 Rubik's Cube. Check out my other video showing you how to solve a 2x2 Rubik's Cube, a 3x3, a 4x4, and even a 5x5. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this 4x4 Rubik's Cube. For the purpose of this video, it would be better if you already knew how to solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube, as many of the movements are the same. If you don't already know how to solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube, then I suggest you check out my 3x3 Rubik's Cube tutorial video, as all the movements and algorithms in that video will also be used to solve the 4x4. I won't be going over in great detail the movements and algorithms that we learned on the 3x3, but we'll get a quick refresher. But if you want to learn exactly what we're doing in detail and their movements, then you need to know the 3x3 ideally. I'm going to try and teach you how to solve this 4x4 cube using the least amount of extra algorithms that I know how, in addition to the algorithms that I showed you in the 3x3 tutorial. Once we arrange the 4x4 into what looks like a scrambled 3x3, then we can finish the cube in the same way as a 3x3, except for a few exceptions when you run into a parity. And I'll explain what a parity is when we come across them. So in this video, I'll teach you a method, so there'll only be three extra algorithms that you need to learn, in addition to the ones that you learn on the 3x3. So now I've just scrambled the cube. The first step into solving a 4x4 Rubik's Cube is lining up these middle pieces. These four middle pieces here are equivalent to one centrepiece on a 3x3 Rubik's Cube. If you remember what I said about a 3x3, these centrepieces are fixed in relation to each other. This blue will always be opposite this green, this white will always be opposite yellow, and the red will always be opposite orange. And we have to arrange them in the same orientation on the 4x4, because on the 4x4, they're not set, they can actually move. And I'll show you how to get them in the right orientation as we solve them. But what you do need to memorise first is you need to memorise what colour is opposite which other colour. For example, I started with green on my other Rubik's Cube videos, and I'm going to start with green on this one for some consistency. And to start arranging these all the same colours, what we need to do, we need to make pairs. We need to pair two greens, another two greens in the same row and join them together. So the first thing to do is to find two greens and join them together. Now you'd be pleased to know, there's no algorithms that you need to remember when we're doing the centres. It's just basically using logic. It's intuitive. I'm basically going to show you the idea of putting them in the right place, how to do it, and then you just go around your cube and sort of figure it out using the technique that I'm going to show you. So you see how we've got two greens here? Well, first, they're on the same plane, so we can't join them anyway, because you move this, you move them both. So we need one on the left and one on the right. So now I've got one on the right, one on the left, so they can move. And then to join them, see how one's on the top, one's on the bottom. Well, we need them either both on the top or both on the bottom. So when I move them, they will pair. So I'll turn this one to the top. So now this one's on the top, this one's on the top, top right, top left. When I twist the cube, I join them together. And then look around for the other greens. I've got another green here. I've got another green here. But this time we're going to twist it that way. So one wants to be on the top, one wants to be on the bottom, which they are. This one is on the right, this one is on the left. So when I turn it, you see we're going to end up like this in a crisscross. Turn it back, so we either want both on the left or both on the right. I'll just put this one on the right. Remember, it's still on the top, so this one's top right, this one's bottom right, and when I twist it, I've got another piece. And this one, this time it's vertical, I want it vertical. I want to bring that up to match the top one. As you can see, they're both on the same side. So we want one on the left, one on the right, doesn't matter which. I'll put this one on the left, and then when I twist the cube, I bring them together. Okay, so that's our first centerpiece done. If you remember when I did the 3x3, I started on the green, and then the final phase that we did was blue. So we know blue is opposite green. So I'm going to put blue on this face. So look around your cube for two pieces. I've already got two in position here. So I'll move them up. If I move them up, well, I've separated my green, so I need to bring them down to rearrange my green. But what can I do if I move them up when I've separated my green? If I twist them onto the other plane. When I bring my green back down, I'll leave it on the top. Find the other two blues. I've got one here, and they're both on the bottom, so one wants to be on the top. Now when I twist the cube, I'm bringing them to each other. This one is on the right, this one is on the left. So if I bring them together, they'll be in opposite corners, so that's no good. So if I turn this one, now this one's in the right, and so is this one. So when I twist them together, they're now joined, and you want them vertical like this. And you see how they're in the same plane. Now they're not, and I can twist it up. However, I've joined these, but I've broken my green again. So if I put my green back in place, I split my blue. So how do I get the blue up here with leaving the green down there? Well, this wants to be the blue. So rather than pushing my blue up, I'll bring these down. If I turn this back to this side, I can bring these down to the blue. And when I'm bringing these down, I'm separating the greens. So I'm bringing these down to the blue. Remember, this is the top, this is opposite the green. Replace them with the blue. I've put them back up, and that has brought the other green back. So now I've got blue and green, two opposite centerpieces. Completed. So now what I do, I turn the cube so the blue is on the right hand side. And now we also need to work out the orientation of the colours as well. We know blue is opposite green. Hopefully you know white is opposite yellow and red is opposite orange. But if I take my 3x3 here, put blue on the right, see I've got yellow on top here, so white should be underneath. It is. And this is orange, but we know orange is opposite red. But we're arranging it in a 4x4, even though we know this is yellow, this is white, this is orange, this is red. We don't know, even if we put yellow here, whether this is orange or this is red. So you could get these a flip-flop and the opposites would still be correct. Now the way I do it, I just think of the colours, red, white and blue. If I twist the cube and I look in a clockwise direction, I've got red, white and blue, and that's how I remember it, red, white, blue. If you get these three in the correct orientation, then the opposites also will be. So I've got my blue on the right, think red, white and blue, and I like to make my layer on the top, on my centerpiece on the top, so when I'm making the next one I can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to make this one white. So find two white pieces, I've got one here, both on the same plane, in the top. We want one on the left, one on the right, so I'll turn this. Now I've got one on the left, one on the right, both in the top. Twist them together. Now I've got a pair, and I want to turn them vertical, and now when I twist it, I won't break them. Remember, because we've made these ones opposites, these won't get pulled apart now when we do all this movement. These are safe, so we're only working on one axis. So look for the other white pieces. I've got one here. I've got one here. This one's on the bottom left, top right. So we need them either both on the bottom or both on the top. I put this one on the bottom. It's on the right. This one's on the bottom on the left. Make sure this one's vertical so we don't split them apart. I'm going to twist them around. And then I want to stand it vertical. Now I've stood this vertical. I can look for my other pair. And I can just twist them together. So now, from a little rhyme, red, white, and blue, red, white, blue. This one, we know, needs to be red. Red, white, blue. We've only got one red piece here. We've got a red piece here, so I'm going to join these together. This one's in the bottom right. This one's in the top right. As I said, first, they need to mean opposites. So now this one's right, this one's left. This one's bottom, this one's top, so they both need to be on the same level. So I'll bring this down to the bottom. So bottom left, bottom right. So when I bring this down, we'll meet. This is my white, so red, white, blue. So this wants to be next to the white. So if I turn this up, when I repair my white, I've now got the first half of my red. Red, white, blue. Look for the other two reds. They're already in a pair. Now, how do I get them to here? Well, we can put them on the same side as the red already because we know that they want to go here. And to get them here, we do it the same when we was doing with the blue. We just bring these to the red. I met these ones next to the other red with the white there and then turn them onto it and then replace them back. Now I've got the red and the white and the blue. And this is what I mean by it's just logic. You sort of work it out as you go. Once you get the basic idea of where to put these pieces to join them, it's just working out. For me, doing the centers is the most enjoyable part because you're not working on a memorized algorithm. You're just figuring it out. So we've got white. Now I'll turn it and do the next one. So opposite white is yellow. We've already got a pair. Turn this vertical so we don't break it. So on this side, oh, we've already got another pair. So to get this here, what we do, as before, we can just bring this to it. Turn it and replace. And now we've completed this one, then the last one has to be complete as well. So we've got red, white, blue. Opposite red is orange. Opposite white is yellow. So now all the centers are complete and in the correct orientation. Now on the last two, you might get in a position where you're like this, where you've got one corner here. You need to figure out, well, how do I get these? Well, think this is a row that we want to keep. This is our yellow row. I want to join this one and this one. So this one is in the bottom right. And what I said, first I want to be on the opposite, then the same layer. So we want this one on the bottom left. Now this one is on the bottom left. But this is the pair we're keeping here. We bring this down. So we've matched them. And then replace them. And bring them back up. You might also get this. Where you've got a crisscross, crisscross. It's basically just choose which one you want to work on first. So let's work on the top. With the top, yellow and yellow is both on the same side. So remember, they want to be opposite. So now I've got opposite, but they're both on the top. Bring it down and you've lined them up. And how do you get them on the top? Well, the red's here. So you know, this one wants to be next to the red. Bring it up. And the same for this one. This one's on the bottom right. So this one needs to be on the bottom left. Bring it down. Now this one wants to be next to the red. And bring it up. Okay, now I've completed the centers.